Assalamualaikum brothers and sisters. So this video will be presenting the last part of common emitter amplifier, which is type number 3, common emitter with bypass capacitor CE. Okay, so common emitter type number 3, as I mentioned just now, has this bypass capacitor CE. Alright, sometimes during the DC design, you need a large emitter resistor. Okay, however, when you want to calculate the gain for common emitter with RE, the gain will be small. So that's why we have this statement here: having emitter resistor can degrade the small signal gain. Okay, therefore we have this type 3 so that having an emitter bypass capacitor will create a short circuit path during AC analysis to avoid the effect of RE. Okay, so I would like to take you back to the circuit that we use in type number 2, where we have common emitter with RE. So in that example, we have obtained the gain V out over VS to be -8.85. Okay, so what I did was I did a simulation using PSPICE, and you can see that I include RE in the simulation. So I run this circuit and using an input of amplitude 10 millivolt, the output is amplified. Okay, and you can see that it is inverted and the amplitude is -89.5, which means that the gain is -8.95. So what if for the same circuit we put a bypass capacitor this time? When we do DC analysis to find the collector current, what happened to the capacitor? It will be open circuit, kan? Right? So you just perform your RTH, VTH, and you just do BE loop as usual. So the DC analysis is the same as what we did in type number 2. Okay? However, now when we do our AC equivalent, capacitor will be short circuit during AC analysis. Therefore, you can see here at the emitter terminal, instead of connecting it to RE, you have this short circuit path. Okay, so the current definitely will go through this short circuit path instead of going through your RE. So that's why it's called a bypass capacitor. Okay, so once emitter is directly connected to ground, it will be the same as type number 1, where your emitter is grounded. The calculation will be much more easier. So what happened is that I did another simulation, and this time I include a capacitor at the emitter terminal, and I run the circuit and see, I have obtained a much larger gain. You can't even see the input, okay, because the output has been amplified to a very large value. The gain has increased to -113 as compared to -8.98 just now when there is no bypass capacitor. Okay, so basically from the calculation and the simulation, you can observe the improvement in terms of the voltage gain. Okay, from -8.95 to 113. Okay, so this is the calculation step. You can see here the calculation for the RI is RTH parallel with RPi. Okay, no more RIB, and also VBE is equivalent to VI, because when emitter is grounded, these two voltages are in parallel. And then as you connect the voltage amplifier to the input signal, the rest of the calculations are just based on chapter 1. Okay, so we have this example here, and similarly the early voltage is infinity, which means that your R0, the small R0, is open circuit. Okay, so the RTH and VTH is calculated for you, and this is the DC analysis. So I would like all of you to try this out, because the steps are all there for you, and you can try until you get the open circuit voltage gain, and then continue to calculate what is the voltage gain V out over VS. Okay, however, for this example, I'm going to do this with you, because for this example, you can see that it is the same as the previous example just now. The only difference is that we have an early voltage equivalent to 200 volt, which means that we have the value of R0. Okay, so I'm going to do this example with you from DC analysis until we get the gain V out over VS. Okay,
so this is your BJT configuration using voltage divider. So let's do the DC analysis first. Alright, so this is your Thevenin parameters. I'm going to change this into the Thevenin equivalent. The question gives the VBE as 0.7 and beta equals to 125. Okay, so the coupling capacitor is at the emitter terminal, but then during DC analysis, this is going to be open. We are not going to include the capacitor in the BE loop, right? So let's do the BE loop in order to calculate what is the collector current. So VTH is 5 volt and RTH is 10 kilo ohm, right? So if I do the loop here, I will have IBRTH plus 0.7 plus IERE minus 5 equivalent to 0. Okay, so I have 10 IB plus 1 plus beta IB 5 kilo ohm equivalent to 4.3. So beta is 125, so IB is equivalent to 0.00672 milliampere, and therefore IC equivalent to beta IB equals to 0.84 milliampere. Okay, so now you already calculated IC to be equivalent to 0.84 milliampere. You can find what is R pi, R naught, and Gm. So R pi is beta VT over IC, and I will get 3.87 kilo ohm. R naught is VA over IC, and it is given that VA is 200 volt over IC, and I will get 238 kilo ohm. Gm is equivalent to IC over VT, and I will get 32.3 milliampere per volt. So these are the AC parameters for the BJT. So now let's draw the AC equivalent circuit. So you can see here I have drawn back the BJT configuration, but I have turned off VTH and VCC. You can see that the CE is here because now you are dealing with AC analysis. Okay, so let's draw the AC equivalent circuit. So this is base, collector and emitter. So you have R pi, current source, and R naught. Okay, so don't forget this is the output voltage measured at the collector terminal. Okay, so for the base terminal, there is RTH connected to ground. Okay, and for the collector terminal, we have RC. Okay, now for your emitter, if you are dealing with tap number 2, you will have to draw the emitter resistor, right? However, because we have this coupling capacitor, you need to include it in the circuit, and it is short circuit during AC analysis. Therefore, your RE will be ignored because the current will go through this short circuit path. So this is your CE, short circuit. So I'm going to redraw this AC equivalent, which is similar to tap number 1. Measured from base to ground. So let's do the steps to calculate your AVOC. So number 1 is the output resistance, and these two are in parallel, are not parallel with RC, and you will get 2.278 kilo ohm. Alright, so step number 2 is calculation of Vout. Vout equivalent to minus GM VBE R naught, so don't forget the negative sign, and you will get minus 73.58 dBE. Okay, so that is the output side. As for the input side, you are going to calculate what is RI. So RTH parallel with R pi, and so RI equivalent to 2.79 kilo ohm. Okay, So the fourth step is representing VI in terms of VBE. So these two are in parallel, VI equivalent to VBE. So this is just like type number one. So next is calculating your AVOC. So next I want to calculate what is my AVOC. So AVOC VI equivalent to Vout. So AVOC multiply with VBE equivalent to minus 73.58 VBE, which is this step. So you can cancel out VBE and you are left with AVOC equivalent to minus 73.58. Okay, so now I can use this to calculate what is Vout over VS when you connect with the input signal. So you can see in the question that the voltage amplifier is connected to the input signal without RS. Okay, so VI will be equivalent to VS. You don't have to do voltage divider. So AVOC VI is equivalent to Vout because there is no load, and therefore minus 73.58 multiplied with VS equivalent to Vout, and the gain Vout over VS is equivalent to minus 73.58. Okay, so that is the answer for this example.